Hi, and welcome back to the second part of setting up the Brain 2 flybolus controller with the Jeti radio system. So in the previous video I showed you what the functions and the meaning of it is and how to map those to specific switches or controls on the radio. So in this video I just want to show the channel mappings and actually going into the Brain and setting it up. Now, if I go to the Brain software and I've started it up and currently I'm connected to my Brain 2 unit, you'll step through the first few steps. The first one is just giving you some general information, then you'll select your servos. Over here you're going to select the X-bus, and then on the next tab it'll actually show you how to physically connect it to the unit. I'm not covering any of that, so I'm just running through it quickly. And then we get to the radio and matching up the actual radio's output, your stick inputs, to whatever the Brain sees. At this stage, everything we've done up until this point was only purely on the radio itself. And what I'll be doing now is, if I go back into the menu, model, and I go to servo assignment, we'll be back with the default servo assignment where I left off in the first video. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to remove all of these channels to show you how you find and map it up. It's a little beyond what you're supposed to be doing, purely because everything would have been selected by default. But it's just going to give you some idea of how the channels and everything map up to the receiver and into the Brain. So I'm just quickly clearing out all of them. And remember, this was all default assignments when you set up the model originally. And then I'm going to zero out throttle and zero out roll. Alright, so I know for a fact that I've got a function called throttle, roll, elevator, and they're controlled by specific controls. Now, what I also know at this stage is if I go to the function curves, I know that my roll and my throttle is a straight line by default. So if I go back and I go to servo assignment, I know if I move the stick, there is a straight function curve behind it, but it's not being transmitted by the radio on any channel yet. So on channel 1, I'm going to map throttle. So if we now go to the Brain software and we have a look at what it's seeing, is you will see that it moves at the bottom on the throttle channel. So that is correct at this stage. Channel 1 is being transmitted by the radio, it's being received by the receiver, and the Brain actually sees it as the correct motion movement. So if I go to channel 2 and I select throttle again, if I look now, you will see that the top bar also moves. So if we look at the top bar, the Brain is expecting aileron there. So I know that the Brain is looking for aileron on channel 2. So if I go back to my radio and I select 2 again and I say make that roll, which I know that I've mapped roll, the function roll, to channel 1 on my radio, which is this, and it's now being transmitted on channel 2. If I go to this and I look here, you will see that my movement of my finger over here is now actually moving my aileron, and that's exactly what I want. The next one would be elevator. So I'm just going to take a guess and say let's put throttle on the third one and we see what's the new one that moves now. And there you will see the second one move. So that is elevator. So the Brain is looking at channel 3 for the elevator. Alright, so what I'm going to do is I'm just going to go back here and I'm going to change it to elevator. Now I know that the elevator function is mapped to this stick movement, and I'm now transmitting it on 3, so if I have a look, you will see that it moves, and again that's the second option, which is elevator. The next one we're going for is channel 4. Again, I'm putting throttle on there because I want to see which one moves in the Brain, and you will see now it's the fourth option. If I have a look at this, this is pitch. So the fourth option is pitch. So if I go to here, I'm telling my radio I want to put pitch. on channel 4. Now again, on stick 4, I've mapped two functions. I've mapped throttle and pitch. So at this stage, I'm expecting pitch to still move, and it does. So we go back to the radio, and we go to channel 5, and we put throttle on there. So if I now look at here, you will also see my nose right, which is the third option, now suddenly starts moving. The third option is tail. So I know the channel 5 is being interpreted as yaw by the brain. So if I go to 6 and I put throttle on 6 and I have a look at which one is moving now, you will see suddenly that heading lock is now moving. So if I go back, that's my tail gain. So I know that function is called gyro sense. If I go to 7 and I put throttle on there, and I look at which one is moving now, the second last option has started moving. Oh, no, that's throttle. You will notice that nothing else is moving. So pitch is moving and throttle is moving. So if I go back here, pitch and throttle is moving, but nothing else. And I'm expecting something else to move. So now I go over here and you will see setup changes, which means brain is interpreting the current setup as that channel. So if I go back here, I want channel 7 to be what I have called bank function. Remember, I called it bank, although the brain refers to this as setup. So I know bank is on there. And then the last one, I'm going to put throttle onto his channel 8. And if I look at it over here, you will now see that second last option. I'm actually lying, the last option, which is the auxiliary channel, is now moving. So I know that that auxiliary channel I want to use for rescue. So I'm going to move down to rescue. And now I know that all of these channels are mapped correctly. So what I've done is I've set up the functions, I've mapped them to a stick, and I have now figured out which channels match up to which brain or the inputs that brain is expecting. So now the last thing I need to do is actually check that the sticks move in the correct direction. So if I only go for the top option, which is aileron. So I'm going to move my aileron left and right. And if you have a look, it's going to be hard to show that slider bar in the middle, but I'm pushing the stick left at this stage, and you can see the slider at the top is moving to the right. So if I go here, you will see that figure picks up, the percentage goes to 54, 60, and that is supposed to go into the negative. So it means that what my Jeti is doing is that when I move left, the brain is seeing it as right, and when I go right, the brain is seeing it as left. So because I've got the channels mapped correctly now, the next step would be servo setup. Now I'm working on aileron purely because that's the first one in the brain setup. If I go from the top, aileron is the first. So now I need to go to roll. Jeti refers to it as roll, brain refers to it as aileron. And I need to reverse the way it interprets, or at least it transmits that channel. And there is the reverse setting. So I go to reverse and I say yes. And now I'm going to push the stick left again. And if I look at that slider in the middle there, the top slider, you will see I'm pushing left and it's going left, and I'm pushing right and it's going right. So what we've done now is we've mapped the correct channel for aileron and it's going the correct way on the brain setting. The last thing we need to do for that channel is the max positive and the max negative value. So if we have a look here, I'm going to push it all the way left and you will see it goes to negative 97. That's close enough, but we should be closer to 100. So what I'm going to do over here, I just need to make sure that it is max positive. I have a suspicion though that it's max negative, but let's have a look. So we go minus 105. So if I go back here and I push all the way left, nope, it was obviously the wrong one. So I'm going to move that one back to 100. And I'm actually going to take this one up to 105. So max positive 105. And now you will see it goes to negative 103. So we've gone a little too far. So I'm going to take that down to 103. And I'm going to move my stick left again. 101. I'm going to take it down one click. And we're dead on 100. So that's the left side if I push the stick left. Now I'm going to push the stick right, and we see we get 97 as well. So I'm going to move back here, and we're going to change this one to a negative 102. So now I'm going to push the stick right again, and there you will see we've got 100. So everything on the aileron channel is perfect now. If I move the stick left, the brain is showing a left input. If I move the stick all the way left, it shows 100%, and right, it shows 100%. And for every single other channel, elevator would be the next one. So I'm going to do one more of elevator. I'm pushing up at this stage, which means my nose should be going forward. But what you will notice, if I get that slider in the middle, is the slider actually goes towards the backside. So again, my setting is reversed. Now this is elevator, so I would have to go to elevator, and the first thing I would do is reverse it. So now my elevator, if I look at the slider, the second slider from the top, I'm pushing the stick up and it's going forward, and I'm pulling the stick back and it's going backward. And if I go all the way back, it says 97. If I go all the way forward, it says 97. So again, I need to change the max positive, and it would probably be 102 as well, and the max negative, 102. And we come in here and we have a look at that one, and we get 100, and we get 100. So now both our aileron and our elevator is set up correctly. And this you just repeat for all of the other channels. The only one which might be funny is the tail gain, because that's on a switch. So if I flick the switch at this stage, you will see it goes to 551, 551. With the Jeti, that's purely because if I go to heli tuning, it's not under the function curves. It doesn't have a straight line like those. You will see if I scroll down, gyro sense doesn't have a function curve. So I'll have to go to the gyro settings menu. And if I flick the switch over here, you will see the position changes. And there's my three options, negative 50, 0, and positive 50. And those I can just change until they get to a gain level which is acceptable for the brain. Obviously you need to read the instructions on the side here. It tells you exactly what those percentages needs to be. But that's how you would map your channels. And then the last one is obviously the auxiliary channel, which is your rescue channel. So if I flick my auxiliary switch at this stage, you see it goes from 103 to negative 103, which means that that channel is also reversed. So if I go back to model and I go to servo setup, and I scroll all the way to my rescue, then I would have to reverse the channel over here, which means at this stage you will see it shows negative 103, and if I flick it up it shows positive 103, and that means that I can use my auxiliary channel for rescue and it will work properly. Anyways, I hope this gives you guys a good idea of how to set it up. If there's any questions, please feel free to ask it on the forum. Again, I'm sure myself and other people will be more than willing to help you guys out. Cheers, bye.